Okay, the thing we are discussing that this is what, this is the button. Now this is the source. And listener will be what? Listener is the event handler. Now after pressing this button, the event is generated and it is showing that the button is clicked, this message. So this is an event handler will generate response to the event. So the Java code will be present and this we call the event handling code. This event handling code is responsible to the event. This event handling code is response to the event and this, that's why it is showing that the button is clicked. This we call the listener. Now we have many listener. We have many listener in our Java. Now listener, we have already seen the user interfaces, AWT interfaces, which we have seen. And for each user interface, there is a particular listener present. Like if for the case of button, now pressing the button, if any event is generated, this will be handled by the action listener. This will be handled by the action listener. Now listener is not the class. Listener is an interface. Now interface means what? Interface means it contains the abstract method. Inside of this interface, there will be the abstract method present. Now we have already seen that the user interfaces, which we have level, button, text field, then our text area, then menu, then we have the choices, then checkbox, then we have all the items which we have seen in our AWT, the items which we have seen in our AWT. For each of these AWT classes, there is a particular event handling or event handler present. For buttons case, there is a event handler which we use, that is the action listener event handler. That means pressing the button, if any event is generated, this will be handled by the action listener interface. If by pressing the mouse, any event is generated, then it will be handled by the mouse motion listener. We call that as a mouse motion listener, or by mouse dragged. We can say mouse motion listener or mouse listener. By this, it will be handled. If any event is generated after pressing the checkbox, then for that, with the listener we use, that name is the item listener. So one by one, I will discuss. But till now, first thing I will discuss, that will be the generated by pressing the button. Generated, the event generated by pressing the button. That I will discuss. So this is what, this is the source and that we call the listener. This is the listener concept. So now what we will do here as the example, if we see that click here. So click here is what? This is the button. And this click here button is the source. Now after pressing the click here button, it is what? The state is changed. The state is changed and the message it is showing that the event is generating. What? Now after pressing the button, the message you see that the button is clicked. So that means the state is changing. The state is changing there. So this state changing is then this event. This will be handled by this event handler Java code. So click here is what? Click here is a button, which is a source. And Java code is what? It is the event handler. And every source has to be registered. Every source has to be registered with the listener. Each and every source. For button, we already said that button, we have action listener. For if we users in that case, AWT checkbox, in that case checkbox, then we have to use the item listener. If in that case we have to use the pointed text field, in text field also we can use the action listener. So like this, the listener or the event handling code should be present. So Java code will be the event handler, and every source has to be registered with the listener. And after registration, whenever the state changes, because after pressing the button, the state is changing, that the state changed and the message is showing that the button is pressed. This is the state change or event occurring, because this is an event that is occurred, that after pressing the button, you are seeing the message. This is an event, or we can say that state is changing there. Then the Java code will execute it and shows the response or execute the response in the occurrence of that particular event. So this is what the event handling all about. Now benefit is what? User interface logic is separated from the event handler logic. So there will be like another Java code present. This Java code will only be used for the event handling. That Java code will only be used for the event handling. So separate code is present for that. This is the benefit. And user interface element able to delegate the processing of an event to the separate piece of code. So the first, I will show you that how the first program of this event handling, it will be clear to you that how it will write this. This is the event handling code we write. Now, in this event handling code, we want that there should be a frame. Inside that frame, there will be a text field, and there is what? A button is present. There will be the button present, and with over that button, it is written. That means the level of that button is click me. Click me, it is written. So like that, a frame should be present and a text field will be there, and there is a button present. This button's name will be, or level of the button will be, click me. And we want that we write something. First, we will write something in the text field. We'll write some statement, and after writing the statement, we press the button. And when we'll press the button, another statement will be shown over in the text field. So first, if we want to do such a program, what we have to do first? We have to use the import java.awt.start. This is what the package should be imported, same as that. The package should be imported there. So this is the package we imported in our program. That means inside the AWT package, all the classes that are present will be imported in our program. Now this is a graphical program, so that's why we want to use that, because we will use this text field, then this button, all are present inside this AWT package. So that's why this package should be imported. So first stage, or the first statement, we import java.awt.star. Okay, then in the next case, the next package we have to use, that is import java.awt.event.star. Now why we use this? All of the event listener will be present in this package. That means we already discussed the four types: action listener, item listener, mouse motion listener, mouse listener, key listener. All of this listener is associated with any AWT graphical program, any AWT component. Like for key listener is what? if we write something through keyboard, then the event is generated. That will be handled by the key listener. If for the mouse, then it will be handled by the mouse listener. If it is the checkbox, then it will be handled by the our checkbox. It will be handled by the item listener. And if it is associated with text field and button, then it will be handled by the action listener. So here we are using this two listener, using this, sorry, not two listener, we are using the action listener because we have a text field and we have a button. So, and the button is generating the event, not the text field. The text field is not generating any event because after you press the button, the another statement is showing. So that is what the event is handled by the button only. Now button is had, if a button is generating event, then we use the action listener. And all of this, what all of this are present inside this java.awt.event package. So we have to import this package because all the listeners are present inside this package. So that's why we import java.awt.event.star. Okay. So two packages we have imported, no problem. Then after that, what we have to do? After that, we use our own class. We created our class A event. This is what? This is our own class and we name it as the A event. Extends frame class. That means over the frame, this all the things should be present in the frame. So that's why we have to import the frame class. And we are able to do this because this frame is present in java.awt package. That's why we are able to use that. So that's why we are extending frame. Implements. Now I have already said that all the listeners are present that are interface. So interface, what we do for the interface? A class implements an interface and an interface extends another interface, but a class implements an interface. That's why we have written implements. And this is the event generating for clicking the button. So this event will be handled by, if any event generated by the button, then that will be handled by the action listener interface. So that's why we have used action listener. And this interface we are able to use because java.awt.event, this package we are importing in our program. Inside of it, all the listeners are present. So that's why we implement action listener. Now, after that, what we have said, inside of it, there will be the text field present. There will be the text field present. So, text field means what? Now, today we have seen that if we want to use something, our user interface, then what we have to do? We have to create the object first. So, that means if we want to use the text field, that means in our program, we have to create the text field object. So we have write like that text field TF. And this is what? This is the constructor we use. A event is what? A event is the constructor. And inside the constructor, what we do? We create the object. So first text field TF equal to new text field. That means like this, the text field is created. Now after creating the text field, what we have to do? We have to set the position of the text field. So by position of the text field, in the last class I have said, for that we have to use the setBound method. Now whom position I am fixing? The position I am fixing of the text field. That means with the text field object, we have to call the setBound method. In the last class, I am setting the position for the button. That's why I have called the buttons object using the buttons object, I have called the set bounds method. But here I am setting the position of the text field. So that means the text field. So this will use here x1, y1 and x2, y2 coordinates. So TF dot, that's why I've used TF here, because in this I am fixing the position of the text field. So now after this, the frame is put, the frame is created, and inside the frame, the position I have fixed of the text field. So text field is created. Okay. And its position are also fixed. Now, after that, what we have to do? We have to use here. I have said that there should be a button also present. Now, if there will be the button present, then that means what we have to do? We have to create the buttons object. So that is done. Buttons class object we have created in our program. Button B equal to new button. And over that, the level of that button will be what? Click me. So button is created. Now after creating the button, over that it is written click me. Click me statement, it is written. Now the button we have created, same as that button's position should be fixed. Now button's position should be fixed means what? We have to call again the set bounds method. But in this time, for with using whose object? Button's object. That's why we have used b.setBounds. And as a parameter, what we have do as a parameter, we have sent the x1, y1, x2, y2. All of this we have sent. And this has done what? This has done our creating the buttons, button and fix the position of it. Okay. So till now we have created the button, we have created the text field, and their position we have fixed, and we also created the frame. Now we have to add this frame, add this button and text field in our program. So because we have created, but now it is not associated with the frame, not associated, we have not associated this text field and this button with our frame. So before that, what we have to do? Now we want that this button will generate an event. Now, if we press the button, the event will generate. Now, we have called that whom this event will generate by whom. If we press the button, the event is generated. It will be handled by the action listener. That means we have to call the action listener by whom object? Button's object. So that's why you see B, we have used B, because pressing the button, the event is generating. So that's why we have used B here, the object of the button dot add action listener. This is what this now, and as a parameter we are sending, this will refer to the current object. Now that means what? When we press the button, an event will be generated. That's why we have called the add action listener, because add action listener will handle the event. And whom event it will handle? It will handle the buttons event. So that's why with buttons object, we call the add action listener. And as a parameter of the add action listener, we pass our object, with current object. That means which object there will be current. This we have passed. Now we have done the event handling of the button. So after event handling of the button, what we have to do? We have to this add this button and text field in the frame. So that's why we have used the add B and add TF. So add B, that means button's object. That means button should be added. Button should be added in the frame. So that's why we have used add B. And text field, TF is what? For the text field object. Now that means the text field will be added to it. So that's why we have used add TF command. That means now the button and text field is added onto it. Now, then our frame size, set size method do what? Set size method set the size of the our item. So here we are setting the using the set size method. We are setting the size of our frame. So set size, we have mentioned the int, we know that as a parameter which we have sent, as a parameter we always send in height and in width. So height and width of the frame we will fix, and set layout. So set layout will be what? How the frame will look like. So default will be what? There will be the flow layout. We already said that is the layout manager. I will discuss by event handling. When the event handling will finish, then I will discuss about the layout managers. So now you know only that the default layout will be chosen. The system's default layout will be chosen. That is set layout method. And if we as a parameter send null, then the default layout will be chosen. And using the set visible, it takes the parameter true or false. So that means the frame will be visible or not. The frame which we created, it will be visible or not. We'll fix that. If we use true, then it will be visible. If we use false, then the frame will not be visible. So like this, we have done. Then we are using public void action perform. Now, that is the thing, this public void action perform. And as a parameter action event class object, this is what, this is a method that is present in the action listener interface. Now you remember, inside the interface, all the method when I have discussed the interface, in that time I have mentioned that any method that will be present inside the any interface, that will be abstract. That means no method definition or no body will be there. That means action listener is what? Action listener has an abstract method present, public void action performed, and as a parameter, action event class object. This is what? This is a method that is present inside the our action listener, that is present inside the action listener interface. And we know that if any abstract method that is present inside the interface, we override that method inside the child class. Inside the child class or the class that is extending, inside that class, we do what? We override that method. That means that this action listener interface will contain this abstract method, public void action perform. And as a parameter of it, that is the action event class object. This abstract method will be contained in this action listener interface. It contains this action listener interface, contains this abstract method. And what we are doing, this action listener is implementing. We are implementing in our own class. We are implementing. That means this action listener, we are implementing this interface. So that means this class which implements, inside that class we can override. So that is what, inside this class we are overriding this public void action perform. And here what we are saying, tf.setText. Now setText method is what? SetText method, that it will be the setText. In the I have discussed in the last class, setText method, using setText we set the text of it. And in which we have set the text? We have set the text in the text box. So that's why using the text box, we call the setText method. And it is showing what? It is showing the welcome. That means some statement I will write inside this. Inside the text box, I will write some statement. And after that, I will press the button. So when I will press the button in the text box, it will show welcome. So anything, any statement I will write inside this text box first, and after that I will click the button. So when I will click the button, it will show the, instead of that, it will show the welcome. This is what, using the set text, we are modifying that. We are modifying. Then in the main, we are calling the, we are creating the object of the actions event. So now if we run, you will see that That is, let's say first I will show you. You see, that is the window that is created. Now, let's say I write some statement. Let's say CSE 2020 to 2024. Now that means what we will write here. After I will press this button, it will show welcome. You see, it is showing welcome there. So that means what? After pressing the button, the event is generating. And the event, what this event is done? It is showing the welcome message. So that is how it works. Okay. It is clear to everyone?
Yes, sir. Hello, sir.
Sir,
wo TF object equal to new text field. Hum sir, wo text field.
Text field. तुम ऐसे भी ठीक बोले हो. ये हम थोड़ा change लिखे हैं. ये तुम ऐसे भी ये direct तुम लिख सकते हो. Text field TF equal to new text field. मतलब इसके लिखने से भी कुछ नहीं होगा. देखा दे रहे. वो हम ऐसे लिखे थे. उसका कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. उसमें तुम ऐसे भी लिख सकते हो. इसको छोड़ के हम ऐसे लिखे थे ये नॉर्मली. ये वाला तुम्हारा नहीं होगा क्योंकि हम तक ग्लोबली डिक्लेयर करना होगा. क्योंकि इस क्लास में भी मुझे यूज करना है तो नहीं तो ग्लोबली मुझे डिक्लेयर करना है. इसलिए उसको हम बाहर में ऐसे डिक्लेयर किए थे, नहीं तो ये जो नॉर्मली है ना इसमें वैलिड नहीं होगा, इस क्लास के अंदर वैलिड नहीं होगा तब, इसीलिए उसको ग्लोबली डिक्लेयर किए थे। हाँ, इसका प्रॉब्लम क्या है बोलो तो, ये जो है ना ये टेक्स्ट फील्ड देखो, ये जो हम लोग जो मेथड है वो जो एब्स्ट्रैक्ट मेथड जिसको हम ओवरराइट कर रहे हैं ना उसके अंदर भी हम यूज कर रहे हैं। नहीं कर पाए इसलिए क्या है तो ऐसे डिक्लेयर करना है, इसीलिए हम उसको अलग से डिक्लेयर किए थे। ऐसे बहुत सारा एक्शन लिस्टनर की तरह बहुत सारा तुम्हारा क्लासेस है, बहुत सारा इंटरफेस है हम लोगों का, जो एक के बाद हम प्रोग्रामिंग में दिखाएंगे एक के बाद। जैसे ये एक्शन लिस्टनर गया, जब चेक बॉक्स के बारे में आएगा चेक बॉक्स में हम उस टाइम यूज करेंगे तुम्हारा आइटम लिस्टनर, जब माउस के बारे में आएगा माउस के टाइम में हम लोग माउस मोशन लिस्टनर यूज करेंगे, और एक्शन लिस्नर और तुम्हारा जो आइटम लिस्नर है इसके अंदर सिर्फ एक ही हम लोगों के एब्स्ट्रैक्ट मेथड प्रेजेंट होता है, बट हम लोगों का जो आइटम जो माउस मोशन लिस्नर है, माउस मोशन के लिस्नर के अंदर बहुत सारा ऐसे हम लोगों के मेंशन है उधर, बहुत सारा एब्स्ट्रैक्ट मेथड, 3 एब्स्ट्रैक्ट मेथड हम लोगों के उधर है। तो ऐसे हम लोग को क्या है, ऐसे हम लोग को ऐसे जो ग्राफिकल ऐसे विंडो बना के ये सब बना के हम लोग यूज करते हैं। तो एक एक को अगर हम देखें तो ये टेक्स्ट फील्ड जो बनाए इसके लिए बनाए हम, ऐसे पोजीशन फिक्स्ड हो टेक्स्ट फील्ड का। देन बटन का अगर देखें, बटन हम लोग क्या है, बटन का पोजिशन और बटन इस कमेंट से फिक्स किए। देन ये जो प्रेस बटन प्रेस करने के बाद मेरा जो इवेंट जेनरेट हो रहा है ये मेरा ये एक्शन लिस्नर हैंडल कर रहा है, जो बटन जो हुआ बटन प्रेस करने के बाद जो मेरा इवेंट जेनरेट हो रहा है, जैसे तुमको स्टेटमेंट लिख रहे हो वो शो कर रहा है और कुछ, तो ये तो क्या है एक स्टेट से और दूसरे स्टेटमेंट आ रहा है, तो ये हैंडल कर रहा है मेरा एक्शन लिस्नर। अब फिर उसके बाद वो फिक्स करने के बाद हम लोग को क्या है, हम लोग को बटन और टेक्स्ट फील्ड को ऐड करना है, करना है मेरा फ्रेम में, और उसके बाद फ्रेम हम फिक्स करेंगे, फ्रेम का साइज फिक्स करेंगे और फ्रेम बनेगा या नहीं वो हम फिक्स करेंगे। देन हम लोग क्या है, ये जो इंटरफेस के अंदर उसके अंदर एक एब्स्ट्रैक्ट मेथड है जिसको हम लोग ओवरराइड करते हैं, हम लोगों का प्रोग्राम ओवरराइड जो स्टेटमेंट दिखता है वो सेट टेक्स्ट मेथड से क्या है हमको दूसरा जो उसके बाद
हेलो सर, सर हम लोग टेक्स्ट फील्ड में जो भी लिखेंगे तो वहां तो वेलकम ही सिर्फ शो करेगा ना, क्योंकि हम और कोई इसमें
तो हम वही सेट किए तो कि तुम अब टेक्स्ट फील्ड के अंदर देखो, टेक्स्ट फील्ड के अंदर तुम जो भी कुछ लिखोगे, जैसे तुम जो भी ऐसे नॉर्मल कुछ लिखो, अब क्लिक मी जो है ये जो बटन है, ये बटन क्या है, ये बटन एक मेरा इवेंट जनरेट कर रहा है, तो इवेंट जनरेट में क्या है, ये सेट टेक्स्ट मेथड में हम सिलेक्ट कर दिए कि वेलकम ही शो करेगा, जो भी तुम लिखो। अब इस जगह में तुम और कुछ लिखना चाहते हो तो और कुछ सेट कर सकते हो, ये तुम्हारे ऊपर डिपेंडेंट है। हम सेट किए कि जो भी हम लिखेंगे उसके बाद जब भी हम बटन प्रेस करेंगे तो मेरा वेलकम मैसेज शो करेगा, यही हम चाहते हैं, इसलिए हम ऐसे सेट किए।
सर जो लास्ट लाइन में न्यू इवेंट लिखा हो, क्या है, ऑब्जेक्ट है सर?
ओ तुम्हारा ऑब्जेक्ट, ऑब्जेक्ट हम जो हम लोगों का क्लास का, ये जो हम लोगों का जो क्लास का ऑब्जेक्ट हम क्रिएट किए, ये तो मेरा क्लास था, ये इवेंट तो जिसके अंदर पूरा हम ये सब किए, तो ये मेरा क्लास था। और मेन के अंदर क्या करते हैं, हम मेन के अंदर ऑब्जेक्ट क्रिएट करते हैं, तो ऐसे डायरेक्ट लिखने से भी हो जाते हैं, समझ लेते हैं हम लोगों का कंपाइलर जो है वो समझ लेते हैं, तुमको ऐसे पूरा लिखने का जरूरत नहीं होता है ऑलवेज कि तुम आउटफिट लिखो ए इवेंट देन कुछ ऑब्जेक्ट का नाम दो इक्वल टू न्यू ए इवेंट, ऐसे लिखोगे। और कभी कभी हम लोग डायरेक्ट ऐसे लिखने से भी हो जाते हैं, कंपाइलर समझ लेते हैं कि न्यू जब भी देखते हैं ना, न्यू मतलब क्या है वो देख ही लेते हैं, न्यू का समझ लेते हैं कि ये ऑब्जेक्ट क्रिएट कर रहा है और ये क्या है, ऑटोमेटिकली ऑब्जेक्ट क्रिएशन कर लेगा। तो हम लोग इधर देखो इसीलिए वो हम स्टेटमेंट नहीं लिखे, जरूरत नहीं है ऑलवेज लिखने का, तो हम ऐसे न्यू ए इवेंट, ये तो मेरा ए इवेंट तो मेरा क्लास था, जो क्लास ए इवेंट क्लास जो है वो क्लास। ठीक है,
यस सर,
ओके, तो समझ में आया पूरा। ऐसे हम नेक्स्ट दिन ऐसे अभी जो है ना, अभी हम एक के बाद एक ऐसे प्रोग्रामिंग दिखाते जाएंगे, क्योंकि प्रोग्रामिंग से क्या होगा तुम लोगों को समझने में भी इजी होगा, मतलब क्या हो रहा है समझने में, ये सब चीज जो है ये समझने में भी इजी होगा जब अगर हम प्रोग्रामिंग की तरह शो करते हैं तुम लोग, तो इसीलिए हम प्रोग्रामिंग के जैसे ऐसे शो करेंगे तुम लोगों को। ओके देन, थैंक यू एवरीवन, आई एम एंडिंग द सेशन।
थैंक यू।
सो तुम लोग का जो इंटरनल है, इंटरनल दो अच्छे से, और इंटरनल के बाद फिर क्लास स्टार्ट होगा तुम लोगों का, ठीक है? ओके, थैंक यू।
सर फिर से